In this video series, we are going to study science chapters of grade 10 SEE exams. Now we are going to start the physics part, chapter electricity and magnetism. So in this part, we'll be discussing questions of said book. Okay, one of your said books. Now we'll discuss questions from effects of current part. Now we'll see questions of group A, very short questions, 1 mark questions, and group B, 2 mark questions each. Okay, so these are the questions. What is heating effect of current? What is lighting effect of current? What is chemical effect of current? What is magnetic effect of current? Yes. So whenever you write your answer, you need to be familiar with the language. You have to use proper words so that you can express the meaning of your answer clearly. Right? So we'll see the answers now. Heating effect. When electric current passes through heating appliances like electric heater, electric current energy changes into heat energy. It is called heating effect. Electrical energy changes into heat energy. It is called heating effect. So you can write answer of lighting effect in the same manner. When electric current passes through appliances like filament bulb, electrical energy changes into light energy, it is called lighting effect. This process is called lighting effect. Okay, now chemical effect. The chemical changes taking place in a solution, occurring in a solution when current is passed into it. Okay, chemical changes occur in a solution when current is passed into the solution. This is called chemical effect. Chemical changes occurring in a solution when current is passed into it. Okay, this is called chemical effect. Example, electrolysis of water, electroplating, these are examples of chemical effect. Okay, of current, magnetic effect of current. A wire, conducting wire or a coil, solenoid, behaves like a magnet when current is passed through it. Okay, when a conducting wire and solenoid or a coil behaves like a magnet when current is passed through it, this is called magnetic effect of current. Example, electromagnet. Electromagnet is made by passing current through a conductor. No, so that is magnetic effect of current. Okay, now question number two. What is heating element? What is filament? These are the questions, important questions. What is heating element? Heating element is a wire or coil used in heating device to convert electrical energy into heat energy. Is called heating element. Any wire or coil that can convert electrical energy into heat energy in device like electric heater, it is called heating element. Okay, so heating element is a nichrome. Nichrome is a heating element. It is made up of nickel and chromium. Nickel 60%, chromium 40%. Okay, nichrome. Nichrome is a heating element. It is an alloy. So it has high resistance and high melting point. Okay, high melting point, as high as 900 degrees Celsius. Write high melting point and within the bracket 900 degrees Celsius. So heating element. A wire or a coil used in heating device to convert electrical energy into heat energy is called heating element. Example, nichrome. Okay, nichrome is usually used as heating element. This is the best heating element. It is made up of nickel and chromium. It has high resistance and high melting point. Okay, similarly, what is filament? Very thin wire of tungsten element, tungsten metal. Okay, thin wire of filament, thin wire of tungsten used in filament bulb. Okay, to convert electrical energy into light energy is called filament. Okay, it also has high resistance and high melting point, as high as 3400 degrees Celsius. High melting point, 3400 degrees Celsius. Okay, the filament is made very thin to increase resistance. Thinness of wire is directly proportional to resistance. Okay, so filament. Filament is made thin, very, very thin, to increase resistance. Tungsten, T-U-N-G-S-T-E, and tungsten filament. Now question number three, name an inert gas filled in filament bulb. Usually common are nitrogen and argon. Nitrogen or argon, either nitrogen or argon, you can write anyone. Inert gas means not reactive. Okay, not reactive. Number 4, what is the function of inert gas in the filament bulb? So inert gas like nitrogen is filled into the filament ball to prevent oxidation and evaporation of tungsten filament. Oxidation, burning, it is the burning of tungsten filament, okay, that is prevented by nitrogen or argon inside the bulb. Okay, if there is simple air, then that contains oxygen, and oxygen will help in burning. Okay, that is why inert gas like nitrogen or argon is filled in filament bulb. Okay, so this is also a common question. Number 2, mercury vapor in fluorescent lamp. Fluorescent lamp is filled with mercury vapor. Yes, so mercury vapor has mainly two functions here. Number 1 is mercury vapor ionizes when current is passed into the bulb. Okay, passed into the fluorescent bulb. So mercury ions are in charged condition. They help in carrying current from one end to another end of the fluorescent bulb, right? So mercury vapor, you know, they form ions, and these ions help in conducting current from one end to another end of fluorescent bulb. Another function, mercury ions and mercury atoms collide among themselves. Collision occurs among mercury atoms and mercury ions. That collision produces UV rays. And finally, these UV rays are converted into visible light. Okay, so the function of mercury vapor, there are two functions. Number 1, to carry current from one end to another end, because mercury vapor forms mercury ions. Okay, mercury vapor remains in ionized condition inside fluorescent bulb. And another one is the collision among ions and atoms of mercury. Collision, okay, collide, that produces UV rays. And finally, these UV rays are changed into visible light. Okay, anyway, they produce UV rays. Okay, collision produces UV rays. That there are two functions of mercury vapor in fluorescent lamp. Number 3, fluorescent powder in fluorescent lamp. Okay, this long bulb is coated with white powder from inside. That is called fluorescent powder or phosphor powder, fluorescent powder. The function of fluorescent powder is to absorb these UV rays and emit visible light, right? So to emit visible light, to produce visible light after absorbing UV rays, that is the function of fluorescent powder, which is coated on the inner surface of fluorescent bulb. Okay, to convert UV rays into visible light. Now next is choke. Choke produces high potential difference, okay, PD, to provide high PD for the flow of current, high PD in the beginning. And starter, the function of starter is to initiate the ionization process of mercury, okay, to excite the mercury ions, right? So to start the flow of current, you can say flow of current, it is just like the contact point of current. Okay, so the function of starter is this. So anyway, choke and starter, these are not very common. Now number 5, give reason. Fluorescent lamp is more efficient than filament lamp. It is very simple to understand, to write the answer. Fluorescent lamp can convert 30% of electrical energy into light energy, right? 30% of electrical energy into light energy, whereas filament lamp can convert only 10% of electrical energy into light energy, only 10%, okay? 90% gets wasted in heating other supporting parts, like the supporting wire. These are, you know, glass bulb. So these are the parts which gets heated due to electrical energy, okay? Only 10% will be converted into light, right? So this way, fluorescent lamp is more efficient than filament lamp, right? So fluorescent lamp, 30% of electrical energy is converted into light. Filament lamp, only 10% is converted into, you know, light. Yes, light of electrical energy. Only 10% is converted into light energy. Now differentiate between filament lamp and fluorescent lamp. Very simple answer for this one. Filament lamp can convert 10% of electrical energy into light. Fluorescent lamp, it can convert 30% of electrical energy into light energy, right? Now, number two, filament lamp, inert gas like nitrogen or argon is filled in filament lamp. Okay, inert gases are filled in filament lamp, whereas fluorescent lamp, mercury vapor is filled in fluorescent lamp. Okay, two important differences. And one more, you can write like this. In filament bulb, tungsten filament produces light. Tungsten filament produces light, whereas fluorescent lamp, mercury vapor produces light. So we'll do the next part, okay, in the next video.